Hi, welcome everyone. So program is to write a program to find the largest or smallest number in an array of 32-bit numbers. So here we are writing a program to find the largest number or a smallest number in a given array. So we array can be of any numbers. So here in this example, we are taking 7 numbers in an array. So out of the 7 numbers, we'll find out the largest number from that array, and we'll save that in some register. So the array of 7 numbers are saved in the memory. So for example, in this program we have taken these values 0444444444222222222, like this 111133333888888999. So out of these 7 numbers, so which is the largest number? It is AAAAA. So that number is the largest number. We will find out this largest number. To find this, we need to know the logic first. So how we will find out this largest number? So we'll see that here. So we have this data 0x444422211133333888899. So in these numbers, we'll find out the largest value. So how we'll find out? So first we need to go to the address. So at which address we have this virus? So we need to find out the address. So here the addresses are, for example, I will take starts from 3C. So address for this is 3C. So next 4 values are incremented: 3C, 3D, 3E, 3F, 40. The next value will be stored in 40. Next value will be stored in 44. Next value will be stored in 48. Next value will be stored in 4. After 48, we will add 4 numbers: 48, 49, 4A, 4B, 4C. That is 4C. Next value will be stored in 50, 4C. After 4C, 4D, 4E, 4F, 50. At 50, we have the number. Next one. Next number is 54. So at these addresses, we will save these values. First, we will compare these values from first address and second address. So in these two values, which is the largest number, we'll save it in some register. We'll save it in some register. To store that, we use program as R2. So the resultant value, largest number, is stored in R2 register. So first, we'll check these two numbers. So which is the highest number we have? So 44 and 22. So the highest number is saved to R2. That is, R2 is having 0x444444444. These two numbers are over. This is my first step. In first step, I am comparing these two values. In next step, we'll compare this value, R2 value, with the next number. What is our next number? 111111. These two values are compared. So in these two values, which is the largest number? That will be saved in R2. So in R2, again we have this same number. Right. So next, these three numbers are over. The next number is this one. We'll compare these two numbers, 33 and 44. So in these two numbers, which is the largest value? That will be stored in R2. So that value is again 44444. These numbers are completed. The next value is what? This one. Right. So we'll compare these two values, 44 and AA. That is the value which is our largest number, which is stored in R2, and this value. So we'll compare these two values. So now, which is the largest number? That is AAA. That will be stored in R2 now. Now the R2 is having 0x AAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAA R2 register. Next we'll compare AA and 8888. So which is the largest value here? Again AA. So this AA value is stored in the next step. So next, these values are compared already. Next, we will compare with this last value, that is 9999999 and A, which is the largest value A that is copied in this R2 itself. So how many times we are comparing? So you can see that this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 times we need to compare. So how many numbers we are taking? 7 numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. For 7 numbers we are comparing and for 6 times. So that is we need a counter of 6. That is n minus 1. So how many numbers? 7. 7 minus 1 is 6. So we will take a counter, so which is having the n minus 1 value. Next, we need to repeat this for every time. Right. In the first step, we will compare these two. Right. So we will compare, first we will copy the first number into R2 and the next number into some other register. These two are compared. Right. So whichever the highest number, that will be stored here. Right. Next, we will compare with this 4 and the next number. So again, we will do the same thing. So here we are incrementing the address. Right. So first time we will compare this with 40. Next, we will compare with this 44, 48. We will compare this with the next address. Next address. So here we will increment these addresses. We need a counter. We need to increment the address. We need to compare this value. So if the compared value, in compared value, whichever the highest number is there, that should be stored in R2. Finally, in R2, we will get the largest number within this array. So we'll see the program. So first, we'll go with largest number. So first, we know that we need to write with area. So this defines a memory area. So that area is given a name, largest. So after that, what type of area it is, that is we are writing a code in this area. So code memory is read-only memory. Next, we'll start the program with entry start. In the first instruction, move R5 comma hash 6. So this will initialize the counter. Why the value is 6? Because we have 7 values to be compared. So that's why it is 6. If I am taking 10 values in an array, this value will be 9. Right. Next is LDR R1 comma is equal to value 1. So here, so what are these values? So we need to give these values, right? So 4, 2, 1, 3, 8, 9, these values. So where are these values are stored? So these values are stored with the given name value 1. So where is that? It is here. Value 1. Value 1 contains 4, 2, 1, 3, 8, 9. All these values are stored at value 1. Right. So we'll copy the address of value 1 to R1. So what do we have in R1? Address. So we can see here. In R1 we have the addresses. Next, we'll increment the value of R1, that is address, to the next 4 bits. So that's why we are using this instruction. And at R1, what do we have at R1? That is the first value. That first value is copied to R2. So now R2 contains 4444. R1 value was what? Previously it was 3C. Now it is incremented with 4 and it will be 40. Next instruction is LDR R4 comma R1 comma hash 4. So here we are moving the next number to R4 and incrementing the value of R1 plus 4. That is, now the R1 was 40, now it will be 44. So at 40, what do we have? That is 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. That 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2 is moved to R4. Right. So R1 value will be incremented. R4 contains 2, 2, 2, 2. R2 is having the first value, 4, 4, 4, 4. R4 is having the next value, that is 2, 2, 2, 2. Next, we'll compare these two. Compare R2 comma R4. We'll compare these two. If the highest number is in R2, we'll jump to loop 1. That is by using this branch if high. instruction. Where it will branch to loop 1. So it will branch to this loop. So if it is having a lowest number, if R2 is having a lowest number, it will copy the content of R4 to R2, that is highest value to the R2. So here, as in our program, so this R2 is having 4, 4, R2, R4 is having 2, 2. So program will jump to the loop 1. Next, we'll subtract this R5 value. What do we have in R5? We have a counter. So we have compared one time, that's why we are decrementing that value. So you initially it was 6, now it will be 5. So we'll compare this value with 0. So that is, so how many times we need to compare? 6 times. So first time we have compared and stored the value in R2. So now how many times we need to compare? Another 5 times. So that's why the decremented value will be stored in R5 and we'll compare it with 0. So whether we have compared all the times, no. So we have compared only one time. That's why we'll compare with 0. So that, so for every time it will be decremented. For the last time it will be 0. So once it is 0, it will jump to the loop. So once it is not 0, that is branch is not equal, R5 is not equal to 0, then it will go back to loop. And it will load the value of R1 to R4. So now R1 is storing this 44 and it will be loaded to R4. And these will be compared with R2. R2 is having the highest number. So these two are compared. And if these two numbers, in these two numbers, whichever the highest number, that will be stored in R2 and will decrement the counter. Counter is compared with 0. So if it is not 0, again it will go back and it will do the same process. So compare instruction here, it will be compared with 0. In this instruction, R5 is decremented for one time. So R5 value was 6. So it will be decremented 6 times and it will become 0 after doing this 6 times loop. So after this, R5 will be equal to 0. So it won't jump to loop 1. It will continue to the next instruction. LDR R4, result. So what is this result? So result address is loaded to R4. Result address is loaded to R4. Where is this result? Result, we have taken a separate area. So here the area is, we have defining the area. Area name is given as data 2. Next, what type of area it is? That is code memory or data memory. This is data memory. Next, so this data memory is read-write memory or read-only memory. Code memory is read-only memory. Data memory is read-write memory. So in this, we are saving result. So initially, the result value is 0. Next, we'll save it, the correct result, to this result place. So this is having some address. That address is loaded to R4. In R4, we have the address of the result. Now, so we'll store the value of R2 to that address. So where is that address? Address is stored in R4. That's why this brackets. So in R4, we have the address. At this address, we are storing what? R2 value. So what do we have in R2? The highest number. Largest number is stored in R2. So this will be copied to the address in R4. Next, we'll stop the program. No op. So this is our array. So we have given 7 numbers. So next we have this area to store the result. So after this, we'll end the program. So we'll write this program and execute. To execute, we need a key software. First, go to project, new MicroVision project. So we'll save our project in drive D, ABCD folder. So I'll give the name large. We'll save the project. So which is our target device? LPC2148. So we'll save it in. So we'll select this LPC2148. and we'll give no, so we won't add any startup file. The next we'll start a new program, so we'll click on new, so we'll write a program. So after writing a program, we'll save this. So we'll save with larg.asm. The file name should be given with an extension asm. So we'll save the program. So once we save this program, we should know that so everything which is coming in blue should be given with a tag, written with a tag. So this loop should come behind, that is without tag. So we'll save this program, and next we'll add this program to our project. So to add this, right click on source group, add existing file. So what is the program name? larg.asm. So we'll add this. So and now we'll close this, and we can see this program is added. So once the program is added, so we'll build this program. So this gives the errors and warnings if we have any in our program. So here we don't have any errors and warnings. So it is showing zero errors and zero warnings. So now we'll run this program. To run this, we'll go for debug. So we'll click on this icon, start or stop debug. Okay. So this enters into a debug mode. So here we have the register values. So this is our main program. So this is the converted assembly program. So here we'll see the memory window. We'll see this memory window here. So in the last program, we have taken this values. So that's why it is giving. So next, we'll start the program. So program can be executed in two ways. We can run whole program by clicking on this, or we can go with step by step. We'll go with step by step. In the first step, what happens? So the value, these arrow marks will be showing the which instruction to be executed. The instruction in executing is move R5 comma hash 6. The R5 value is initially 0. Now it will be 6. Next, LDR R1 comma is equal to value 1. So at value 1, what we have? These things, this array of numbers. So the address is saved to R1. So what is that address? 3C. So we can see here 3C 0. X3C. So at 3C, what do we have? So as I said, these array values will be saved here. So these are the array values 4444444222222222211111111. So all these values are saved here. So these values are saved in little endian format. Next instruction is LDR R2 comma R1 comma hash 4, that is R1 value, that is 3C, that is incremented with 4 in R1, that is 3C. 3C at 3C, what do we have? That is copied to R2. So you can see that in R2, value is 4444. This 3C is incremented with 4 and it becomes 40. Next, we'll take the next number, that is 22222, in which register? R4, and R1 is incremented to point the next value. That is R1 is incremented 44. Now what we have is 22222. That value is copied to R4. So now these two values are compared, R2 and R4. R2 and R4 is compared. So whichever the highest number, we'll save it in R2. Next, we'll compare these two, and it will jump to loop 1. So that is R2 is having the highest value. That's why it has jumped to the loop 1. Next, we'll decrement the counter. What do we have in counter? R5, 6. So now decremented with 5. Next, we'll compare this 5 with R5 with 0. So is it equal? No. So if it is not equal, branch if not equal to loop, it will jump here. So you can observe that. So it jumps here. Next, it will take the next value, that is 1111 in R4, and R1 is incremented. So next, in this we will compare R2 and R4, which is the highest number? R2. So that's why we will keep it in R2 itself, and now we will decrement the counter. Counter was 5, now it will be 4. So like this, so which is the highest number?
that will be saved in R4. So how many times we need to press this step? So until we get this pointers at no op. So that loop is run executed for 6 times. Now you can see that R5 value is 0. So we'll compare R5 with 0. Is it equal? If it is not equal, it will be jumping to loop. Now it is equal. If it is equal, it will come here. So we are saving the result address in R4. What do we have the resultant address? That is 4000. So we'll see that 4000 value, that is 0x, not 4000, 4 followed by 7 zeros. We'll give enter. So at this value, we don't have anything. So now, so we will store. Next instruction is to store R2 value into R4. Address given in the R4. What is the address we have? 4. So at R2, what do we have? A. That value is saved here. So we can observe here. So the value is A. So this is how the result is saved. We have saved the result in memory. So this is how we'll find out the largest value. To stop the debug, we'll click on this start or stop debug session. Next, we'll find out the smallest number. So in the same program, so we'll copy the same program. So we'll take one more file and we'll check for the smallest program. I will save this as small.asm. So here, what do we need to do the changes for smallest program? So to find the smallest value. To find the smallest value, coming to this, so here, so while comparing these two values, the largest number is kept here in R2. So now we'll keep the smallest number in R2. So this changes we need to do. So to do that, in the largest program, so we'll compare two values, R4 and R2. And if R2 is highest number, we'll branching to loop 1. So now we will change this BHI to BLS. BHI to BLS. Branch if lower or small. So we'll change this in our smallest program, BLS. So if we change this, so the smallest number is saved to R2. So here, if we have the smallest number in R2, it will branch. Branch if smallest or same number to loop 1. So if we have largest number in R2, the smallest number is having in R4, that will be copied to R2. So single changes. So only the change we need to here do is BLS. So this program is smallest program. So I will give the name smallest. So we'll save this. I will remove this largest program. To remove this largest program, right click on large.asm, remove large.asm, yes. Now I need to add this smallest program. So we'll click on, right click on source group, add existing file. So what is my file name? Small.asm. I will add this. Build this program. So we have zero errors and zero warnings. So we'll debug this program. And we can check that the smallest number is stored in R2. So here 44 and 22 is compared. The smallest number is 22. That's why R2 is having the value 22. Next is 22 and 11 is compared. So you can see that 22 and 11 is compared, which is the smallest value, 11. So that value is stored in R2. Next, it will be compared with 33, 11 and 33, which is the smallest number, 11. That 11 is stored in R2 itself. Next value is AA, a and 11 is compared. So which is the smallest number? 11, that will be stored in R2. Next is 88 and 111 is compared, which is the largest value, smallest value, that is 1111, that is saved in R2. So this will be continued for 6 times. And now the value of R5 becomes 0, that is counter is 0. So once the counter is 0, we'll store the resultant address to R4. What is the result address? That is 4000. So we have already taken this 4000 here in the memory window. So now at 4000, what do we have? We have a zero values. So now in the next instruction, we'll store the smallest value. What do we have in R2? Smallest value is 1111. So that value is stored in this memory. So we can see that 1111 is stored. Now we'll stop the program. Come out of the program. So we'll stop the debug. So this is how we can find out the smallest number and largest number. Fine. Thank you.